Hello traders, and welcome to another tutorial. And in this video we'll be talking about how to trade Fibonacci levels like a pro and using Fibonacci levels to find high accuracy retracement opportunities. So let's see what we'll cover in this video. So we'll go over briefly what are Fib levels for, the most important Fib levels for you to use in your chart, some mistakes beginners make so you don't make them, and how to use Fibs like a pro. And we'll go over some examples of good and bad uses of Fibonacci. Okay, so let's go over to the chart. So here we have a daily chart. In this case, it's the Aussie dollar. And Fibonacci's are just a method of identifying a zone, an area, an entry level for you to enter a trade, a place where the market has a higher probability of turning around and continuing on its way. So in this case, we have a market that's beginning to trend, creating lower lows, and we have the swings from high to low, and we have a Fibonacci, our Fibonacci levels here. Now, the Fibonacci is just there to give you an idea of where the market is going to turn or where you are going to look to place a trade, but it is not a method of entering. So it's just there to increase the probability, just to give you that bit of confluence, that bit of strength to your setup. So just bear that in mind. That's what Fibs are for, but they are not a, let's say, be all and end all of your setup. So now let's just go over the levels. We have multiple levels of the Fibonacci, but there are a few key levels to look at. Now, in another video, we'll cover the extensions, but in this case, we have the retracements. So the key levels really are the 61.8 or 62, and the 70, the 0.705 or 70.5. The rest you can delete to make things much simpler, much clearer for you. And these will be the primary levels to focus on. Nothing is exact. Nothing is going to be to the pip, but you will have a very good indication. And that's what a Fibonacci is for. It's an indicator. Okay, so now we've drawn a Fibonacci. We have our levels, so we can see that we have this area to look at for the market to make its retracement, and somewhere around here to turn around and then continue on its way. Right, so now let's just go over some of the mistakes that beginners make. The first mistake that beginners make is they only use the Fib level as an entry. So they're just trading based on the Fib level alone. So they say, when the market reaches here, I'm going to place an order, in this case a sell, and when the market reaches this point, I'm going to place my stop loss and then place my take profit wherever it goes, and whenever the market hits, then I assume that it will start turning around. Now, that is not a high probability way to place a trade, because Fibonacci's do not move the market. Fibonacci's are just an indicator of where the market will move. So using only the Fib level is not a good idea. Then the second thing is just trading using the levels blindly. So some people look at the Fibonacci and assume that Fibonacci is so strong that just because it's there, then this is where the trade will turn around on this level, or this is where the trade will turn around on this level. Just because it's a good Fibonacci level doesn't mean that it's a good trade. So just bear that in mind. The other thing is, when you are using Fibonacci for retracements, it's best to use it when there are clear market swings. So we want to see a clear trend and retracements happening. We don't want to see a ranging market or a market that's not very clear in its direction. This is risky and lowers the probability of a trade working out. And we don't want to take low probability trades. So for example, we have here the market has kind of stalled, and this would not be the best trade to take because the market is ranging at this moment and we want to wait for it to start coming out of the range, making a new lower low. And when we have a clear direction, then that's when we want to trade. The other mistake you don't want to make is trading every level of the Fibonacci. So we've already removed those, and because there are so many levels, everybody thinks that each level has a significance. So take those levels out and focus on one or two, preferably one level that you are going to focus on. Obviously, the higher the level, the bigger the retracement is going to be and the better the price you're going to get. But of course, the market doesn't always turn around at those higher levels, even though they are preferable. Now let's move on and talk about how to actually use Fibs like a pro. So we've already touched on some of the points. The first point is use Fibonacci as a confluence with your trading. So for example, you have your trend lines. You may have a trend line break as another confirmation, and other factors together with a price action on the area. So you want to use several things at the same time to mark out your area to confirm your trade setup. The second thing is wait for actual confirmation. So we already spoke about not trading blindly off the level. We want to wait that there is some kind of confirmation price action at the level, and then you want to take a trade for it to go in your direction. What you will see often is the market will spike right through a level and come back down. And many times that happens because of the market structure and because of liquidity. So if you do see the spike, you do see aggressive price action, similar to spikes like this. And we see those wicks, candles with wicks. That is a good indication, that's a good sign for you to place a trade. Then we want to use the market with clear swings. So we've already spoken about the fact that we don't want to trade it with a ranging market. We want to trade it with a market which is trending, and we have clear swings forming. In this case, we're waiting for that second swing over here. Then we already spoke about not using several levels. So in this case, we've identified a zone. I'm using two levels here, and that creates a focus point. So in our example here, let's just observe what happens. The market comes into our zone, and here it's best to wait for some price action. We had, on this case, the 61 level respected. We had that wick, and the market eventually moved in our favor. So you need to establish the rules for yourself. What will happen at that zone, at this area? In this case, it's a nice level of supply and demand, support resistance, and fits in with all the criteria. The trend line break here, the new trend line coming down, But whatever your confluence rules are, you want to use them with that setup. Right, so let's start with a few examples. Here, let's look at some good and bad examples. Let's start with some bad examples of what you don't want to do. So many times traders will have different Fibonacci levels, and here we have 50 and 60, 61.8, 62. So some will say, well, okay, if it hits the 50 and bounces off, I'm going to enter. And then if that fails, I'll take the 62. And then maybe if that fails, I'll take the 78. You are setting yourself up for failure, because you're going to have many losing trades, and we don't want that. We want accuracy. So let's just see what happens here. In this case, the market hits the 50 level. My preference is 62 or 70.5, and I'm going to wait for that. So if it matches with all the other trades, but in this example, all the other confluences and rules. But in this example, let's just talk about what traders usually do. And the bad example is the fact that they blindly trade off a level. So if you entered that short, the market came and stopped you out. If now you're entering on the 62, just because of the level, the market went in your favor. And what happened is, again, market stopped you out. So if you place the trade here, just because it was a 61.8 level, a short with your stop loss somewhere above, above the previous swing, if that's what you do, then again, the market came back and stopped you out. So that's not a good example. It's an example of not a good trade setup, because just using those levels alone, as you can see, even though the market broke a trend line, came back to retest, it still didn't move in the expected direction. So that's one example. Okay, so now let's cover an example of a good trade. We have a trending market. We have lower lows and lower high points. As you can see here, we can draw the trend just to make it obvious. And now we're expecting another swing. So we've drawn our Fibonacci. We have our zone or our area of interest. So it'll be somewhere around here. We also have other confluences. For example, supply and demand, support and resistance area. That's been respected multiple times. So let's just draw that out just to make it clear. It's been here, it's been here, it's been tested here and here and here. So very, very obvious, very, very clear. Now what we can do is we can see that our expectation is for the market to turn around somewhere around here. Now we wait for price action and we see what's going to happen. So we have here an engulfing bar, a reversal bar, a reversal price action pattern. And we can see that now there are a lot of reasons to take this trade. Whether it goes in our favor or not doesn't matter, but this meets many criteria and has many confluences. So in this case, you can enter that trade. This is the direction we expect it to go in. And now let's see what happens. It also, as you can see, went within the zone, 61, didn't quite touch the 75. We've drawn the Fib at the obvious spots from high to low here. Just you taking the most obvious helps a lot, whatever is clear and stands out in front of your eyes. So let's just see what happened in this case. The market dived south and we've got the result we were looking for. So just to summarize, look for the clean and clear setups and use the Fibs wisely. Do not depend on them. but use them in combination with other factors within your trade setup and within your predictions for the market. So be very wary that the fibs are an indicator. They are just there to help you. They're not there for you to depend on and count them as the be-all and end-all. Thank you very much for watching, and you can now start practicing with the Fibonacci levels by backtesting those levels within your trading system and experimenting to see what works best for you. Thank you, and see you on the next tutorial.